She had a tremble to her, the inner tremble you could feel with just a hand on her shoulder. I saw her in the grocery store, had not seen her in some months. I asked about her kids and husband, and when I did, her eyes watered, her chin quivered, and the story spilled out. He'd left her. After 20 years of marriage, 3 kids, a dozen moves, gone. Traded her in for a younger model. She did her best to maintain her composure, but couldn't. The grocery store produce section became a sanctuary of sorts. Right there, between the tomatoes and heads of lettuce, she wept. We prayed. Then I said, you'll get through this. It won't be painless, it won't be quick, but God will use this mess for good. In the meantime, don't be foolish or naive, but don't despair either. With God's help, you will get through this. Audacious of me, right? How dare I say such words? Where did I get the nerve to speak such a promise in a tragedy? A pit, actually. A pit so deep, the boy could not climb out. Had he been able to, his brothers would have shoved him back down. They were the ones who had thrown him in.